So you downloaded the source files, and it really doesn't matter which project from any of the courses of the coding basics. And in any of them, you'll find your project folder when you unzip it, open it up. And when you open it up, and let me just drag this into our view, you'll see that there are two folders. There's your source folder and your deploy folder. What does that mean? In Flash, like in most other programming languages, well, in all programming languages that compile. And what does that mean? There are languages that don't compile, like JavaScript. And basically what that means is it's languages that on the user system, the computer then has to read your code, figure out what's going on, translate that into a language that your computer could actually understand, and then run those applications. Flash is not one of those type of applications. Flash is from the type of applications that you actually compile. And compiling basically means that it translates that into some sort of machine language that is much easier than, it's less work for your computer to then decrypt and understand it. And I'm really talking like in very, very vague words, because it really doesn't matter the ins and outs of the technicalities more than saying that you have your source files, which is your humanly readable files and configurations and source and all the things that you're going to work with your editors. If it's your Flash CS3, CS4, CS5, maybe even CS6 when it comes out. So it really doesn't matter which version of Flash you're working as long as it could run the type of files, which we're talking about is AS3 files. And those are your source files. But because we want to compress the files, we want to make sure that it's as close to machine language as we can, so it's easier on the processor, that the files are smaller and so on, we compile the files. And we compile them in different formats, depending on the platform that it's supposed to go to. If it's a desktop application, we're going to compile it differently. If we're going to run it on the web, we're going to compile it differently. If we're going to compile it for a phone, we're going to compile it differently. Because different operating systems, different platforms, demand different low-level interactions with the machine. In a way, it's like a translator. Speaking in the most simplistic way is what are your source files are then translated into a mediator language that then what your end user or end computer is capable of understanding. Why am I saying it's a mediator language is because we're not compiling it down into machine code, which machine code would probably be 0101. We're not doing that. We're compiling it into an intermediary language, just as Java is, if you're familiar with Java. And it's basically it's like a mini language. And basically, if you have Flash running on the plugin running on your browser, then that Flash plugin is the translator that then translates all what it needs to translate into your application. So in a way, there's three steps. There's your source, then there's your deploy, which is your intermediary files, and then there's your Flash player, which actually takes those files, decrypts them, and then breaks them even more apart and gives information to your computer how to run it. But from what we care about really is just that we have our source and we have our deploy. Our source will never upload and send to anyone if we don't want people to access our work that we've worked on. If we only want them to view it, then we'll only show them our deploy files. We'll only post to the web those deploy files. We'll only email those and so on. So with that said about source and deploy, let's see what file formats Flash, well, not all the file, obviously we're not going to talk about all the different file formats that Flash supports because that's not our main focus, but let's see what are the file formats that we're going to be working with in all the videos in this category of programming basics. So in our source files, we're going to find two different types of file types. We're going to find our FLA file type, and we're going to find our AS file type. Our FLA file type is the most old and kind of like the first from the old and good days of Flash. And it's still here, and it's very important still. And although there's ways to work without it today, it's still one of the most popular ways of working with Flash. Now, what are the FLA files? The FLA files are for our sake of our workflow. Our FLA files is basically our heart. It's where we start everything up. On the other hand, I'm going to first explain what the AS file is because it's going to make it a little bit easier. Our AS file, on the other hand, is our script. Here we're going to put all our code. It's only text. Well, our FLA file is kind of like our hub, our library. We could put assets in it and images, and we could put code as well if we wanted to, but we prefer not to. We're going to put all our configurations and all the things that we want to set up for our file. So our FLA is kind of like the hub where everything starts from. And then we could choose to use external files if we want to, or we could not. But we always need to start from our root. And while we're working on CS3, CS4, CS5 in our scenario, we're going to always be working on FLA file formats throughout the experience, throughout the basic coding tutorials. Now, there's obviously differences in different file types that, for example, in CS5, a new file type was introduced that could replace FLA file formats. But we're not going to go into those granularities right now because that's not our main focus. And we're going to create separate courses to go into those details after we get our basic programming concepts set up. But you could always jump and go to separate materials that aren't necessarily dependent on knowing programming. Like file formats are not necessarily connected always to knowing how to program. Okay, so what is our AS files? Our AS files always contain classes, and we're going to dig deep into what are those classes. Well, not always, but in our scenario, they're going to always hold class files. Traditionally, in older versions of Flash, you used to put external files, no matter what external files, you could put external files just so they'll be external. But in AS3, the preferred way of working is putting classes into your AS files. And the way that we set up our file structures is that we have our main, and most of our videos are going to be main.as. And all our code is going to be sitting in main.as until we dig deeper into understanding what classes are. Now, what are all the rest of the files from 02 all the way to 11? These are associated with the video number that you're watching. Although in this tutorial, it's not. In every other course, when you download the courses and you see the different numbers, these numbers correlate to the video that you're watching. So if you want to grab the code instead of typing it on your own, or you want to revisit the code later on, you could always open up the AS file and grab it. Okay, so that's really it about our source, where we said our FLA is our hub where all our assets are sitting, all everything that's related to our project is sitting for now. And in our AS files is always going to be a class, which you don't really know what that is yet, but basically from our perspective right now is all of our code is going to sit inside of our AS file type. Now, what's inside of our deploy? Let's look into our deploy. In our deploy folder, we're going to, most of the time in our scenario, again, and there's a lot of different deployments. It really depends to where are we going to publish. But for our sake of coding basics, we're always just going to do the basics, which is our Swift, which is basically our compiled application, which our compiled application is basically compressed and minimized and translated into a closer level to machine level programming language, where it's easier for the processor and for the Flash player throughout the different operating systems and platforms that Flash player runs on these days, making it easier for it to actually understand it the same way throughout without the overhead of actually compiling on the runtime, or in other words, are actually translating our human readable code into machine readable language. Now, as we said, JavaScript is a language where it doesn't compile, or it compiles on the fly. So when you go into a browser and it's JavaScript heavy, a lot of times you're going to see that it's slower than a Flash application. And the reason why it's slower than a Flash application is because your browser actually has to first understand what that copy is before you could actually start interacting with it. Now, modern browsers have a lot of different interesting ways of dealing with that, such as compiling it on the fly and so on. But the end point is because our applications are pre-compiled, we have a little bit more control over our content. That's one, because people can't just see our code directly as easily. And two, it cuts down the amount of time that it takes the browser and the user's computer to understand what's going on, as long as they have their Flash player, they're more or less ready to go. All right, so that was our Swift, which is a really critical file. Now, we wouldn't want it by mistake, because I've seen that so many times, You don't want to upload your FLAs or AS files by mistake onto a website, especially not if you're building it for a client. It's very important to differentiate between those two file types, and that's why I'm deliberately, throughout all the projects, I'm setting the source in one folder and the deploy in another one, and it's a very good practice to always separate it. Now, your HTML file, we're not going to dig too deep into what HTML is, but HTML is our wrapper for Flash, which is going to enable us to run our application in a browser. Although in our coding basics, we're really not going to run it on a browser, so we're not too concerned about the HTML file. It's just the default file type that's added into our project when we compile it through Flash CS3 and up. Well, previous one versions as well, but now that we're talking about AS3. So that's all I really have to say about our file types for now. And really, these are four file types that you kind of have to memorize and kind of make sure that you really know what they are. And we said we have our FLA, which for our sake right now, all we have to know is it's our main library where all of our assets are sitting, or all our everything starts from, all the commands, all the initiation process starts from here. This is the heart of our source file. This is what actually compiles. And then we have our AS files, which are external files that depend on our FLA. So in our FLA, we're actually going to link these external file to our FLA. Without it, it wouldn't know that it's connected to our FLA. Now in our deploy file, we said, we said our FLA is our main source file. It's where we have our assets. It's not text. It's usually bigger files. It's could have text in it, but it's not something, you can't open that in a text editor. While your code and external files are text. They're basically text. You could open it up in a text editor. It's small files. And then we're talking about our deploy, which we said our deploy is basically our Swift. What is our Swift? Our Swift is basically, if I go back to our FLA, it's our FLA plus any other external assets that our FLA requested for in compiling time, and we're going to see what that means. And in compiling time, it then compiles it and compresses it and puts it all into one bundle, into one file. Our HTML file is just our wrapper file that we could use to run our application in an HTML page. Okay, so those were our four file formats that we really need to make sure that we're comfortable with. The next step is load up your version of Flash. It really doesn't matter which one, if it's CS3, CS4, CS5. And we're going to show you the differences between them.